what all the people say. You're riding high in April, shot down in May. But I know I'm gonna change that tune when I'm back on top in June. I said that's life.
That's life.
And as funny as it may seem, some people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I don't let it get me down. 'Cause this fine old world, it keeps spinning around. I've been...
All right, now tell me about the murder.
So a few nights ago, George was working in his home office, and then he was shot.
Are there any suspects or any clues left behind?
The cops didn't find anything, just these bloody papers on George's desk.
Thank you, ma'am. My partner and I will look over these and give you a call tomorrow if we find anything.
Is there anything else you'd like us to know?
Well, at the time, George was working in some kind of business.
Drugs. But his main job was working at some warehouse place.
You keep saying you got something for me. Something you call love, but confess. You've been a messin' where you shouldn't have been a messin'. And now someone else is getting all your best.
Hey, I think I found something.
What'd you find?
It looks like a company name, Whitlock's. That be something?
Check the phone book.
Let's see. Arvin Whitlock, 1277 Free Street. That be something?
I don't know. Let's check tomorrow.
All right. Wonder how scary that guy is.
What do you want?
Are you Arvin Whitlock?
Maybe. What's it to you?
We're here to ask a few questions about George Archer. Have you ever heard of him?
Can't say that I have.
Sir, if you answer these questions honestly, this will go by a lot faster.
Honest, I haven't heard of him.
All right then, tell us your line of work.
Who are you guys and why are you asking so many questions?
I'm Private Detective Chris Booker and this is my assistant Alice. Now tell us your line of work.
I don't gotta tell you anything.
Sir, we're just trying to solve this case, and research has led us here. Now talk.
I see.
That man's definitely hiding something.
You think? I'm going in. Tell me about George.
I said I don't know.
I know you're lying.
Get out of my house.
That man is nuts.
Look what I found.
It's a business card with the same logo that was on George's paper. There's no address, just a phone number. I'm gonna call it.
You should go to the bar and do it. It is happy hour.
Good idea. Can I use your phone?
You have to buy a drink first.
All right, let's have a shot then.
Coming up. Who are you trying to reach?
Whitlock's.
They've been closed down for weeks now.
Really? Why?
Someone got shot and they had to close them down. The rest of the people left, got another job.
Huh.
I gotta go help someone else now.
Alright.
Tommy got him. They're at the warehouse now.
Excellent.
You better give me my money.
You'll get your money when the detective is killed. Can't have him snooping around or we'll all get busted.
So you're looking for Whitlocks, huh? You're here.
Who are you?
This is one of our warehouses. I'm Arvin's assistant and the leader of these people. Boss told me he doesn't want any more detectives snooping around for clues.
I knew it. Arvin killed George.
That's none of your business.
Tell me, who killed him?
Me. Arvin hired me to kill him.
Police! Open up! I said police!
Where are you?
I can't believe you fell for it. You see, I did kill George. That bastard was stealing half our inventory, so I put my best man on it.
Yeah, who I killed.
Tommy's not dead. Who do you think's down there killing that officer?
Let me out of here.
Hey, I don't think so. I guess that's what they say. You win some, you lose some. That's life.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full.
The job's done now, where's my money?
Here's your money.
Over and over.
Next time, I want my money up front. I'm gonna go to the bar and it's happy hour.
Okay, you're paying.